Good afternoon everyone. Today we learn about the biomolecules, okay? Chapter 9. Previous day we learn completed the animal plant kingdom, and we know that all the living organisms are made up of different types of the components, okay? Carbon, hydrogen, protein, lipid, fats, carbohydrates, all are the important for our growth and development. Not only that also helps to repair the tissue, that form the different organs, different parts of the body. So living organisms are made up of different types of the biomolecules. Not only living organism, our earth crust, the non-living organisms are also made up of the biomolecules. But carbon and hydrogens are the most important biomolecules, okay? Carbon and hydrogen. Carbon and hydrogen are the most important biomolecules. So the amount of the carbon and hydrogen is the present more in the living organism than the earth crust. So that's why earth crust is the non-living, but our living organism contains the large amount of the carbon and hydrogen. So okay, that is mainly difference between the earth crust and the living organism. So but the biomolecules also are the important for our body, different organs, and obviously living and non-living part also. Good afternoon, Diti Priya. And so living tissue, how could you know that living tissue contains the biomolecules, and which components are the made up of the this is contains the biomolecules? You know that carbohydrate, protein, fats and lipids, some are soluble in acid, some are insoluble in acid. So how could you observe that which type of components are present in the living organism? First you have to take a living or cells, that may be a plant parts, leaf, anything, or livers of the living organisms. Then you grind it in the trichloroacetic acid, okay? Then you can see that some functions of the part, that is acid soluble, and some are the acid insoluble. The organic and inorganic material are entered inside the acid soluble parts, and another group that is present in the organic and inorganic, that is acid insoluble, okay? So first biomolecule, that is the most important, carbon and hydrogen. How could you observe the biomolecule? First, living organisms, living parts, anything that may be vegetative parts, that may be liver or any parts, that grind in trichloroacetic acid. Trichloroacetic acid, that is Cl3CCOH, okay? Cl3CCOH, okay? There will be two parts will be formed, okay? One is acid soluble, another is acid insoluble. Okay, so this is two types will be formed. First one, you have to take a living parts, liver, that may be vegetative parts, anything, and that you can grind it in the trichloroacetic acid, and after some times you can see that there is two function will be present. One is the acid soluble and another acid insoluble. Okay, now you can see that different molecules are present on the earth. There is the, you can see a box in your book, that there is the some components are present in also earth crust, that present in also the living organism, but the percentage vary in between them, and for the design that separate the living ones from the non-living ones, okay? So what is biomolecule? You can say from that the living organism, the carbon content living organisms are called, that present in the carbon content molecule that present in the living organism is called biomolecules, okay? So carbon, what is biomolecules? Carbon contains content molecule present in living organism. So you have seen that glucose, you have seen carbohydrate, protein, lipids, amino acids. There is one carbon group must be present. Okay, so this type of molecules are called biomolecules that contains carbon, and there is some organic, and the biomolecules are also called organic molecules also. But inorganic, what is inorganic molecules? That does not contain the carbon groups. Okay, phosphorus, sulfur, calcium, magnesium, then they does not contain carbon. Okay, that is inorganic. If you difference observe what is the organic compounds or inorganic compounds, how it is present in the living organism, ma'am, so you just have to take a living part, that is maybe liver, any dry leaf, then you dry it. You know that there is some weight that is present in our body due to the water. Okay, and minus water, the weight of our body is called dry weight. Okay, so when you dry it, there the water will be evaporated, so the dry weight only remain on that piece of the liver or on this type of the vegetables. Then you burn that. Okay, and after burning, the carbon that present inside that living organisms, that will be evaporated in the gas was formed, that is carbon dioxide. So water has also gone, carbon dioxide also gone, the ash will be remain. Okay, when you observe the or examine the ash, you can see that there is some calcium, magnesium will be present. Okay, so that they are inorganic molecule, phosphorus, anything. So carbon and biomolecules, small amount of the living tissue, small amount of living tissue, dry it and burn it. Okay, burn it. When you burn that tissue, the CO2 and water vapor removed, water vapor removed, you know that, and only which will be remain, that is ash. Okay, so after that, so first one, that is the small amount of the living tissue, then dry it, then burn it, then you can see that water and CO2 will be evaporated and ash will be remain on the place. Okay, so ash will be formed, and ash contain calcium, magnesium, sulfate, phosphate. Okay, calcium, magnesium, sulfate and phosphate. Okay, so this will be remain. And if you seen this type of compound, you have already read in your chemistry, they are called aldehyde group, ketone group, aromatic group. But when you see in the biological concept, these are called amino acid, nucleotide, fatty acid based. Okay, so they are also contain the some chemistry group. When you see the chemistry concept, they are called magnesium, calcium, sulfate and phosphate. And when this contains the if you see that biological concept, that remains that is called fatty acid group, nucleotide group, amino acid group. Okay, so next, what is amino acid? Okay, amino acid means one amino group must be present and another acid group will be present. Okay, amino group means you know that NH3 group, and acid group, that is carboxyl acid COOH, will must be present. Okay, amino acids that contains one amino group plus one acid group. Okay, that is Ditipriya, chapter number 9, biomolecules. Amino group and acidic group, carbon, when the carbon, there amino acidic group, that is COOH, carbon present, and amino group, that is NH3 group, obviously present. When this carbon is present in the, there is some valency are also present, valency, and there is the alpha present. When carbon present in the alpha position, that is called alpha carbon group, okay. That is called alpha carbon group. And the amino acid that contain hydrogen group, carboxyl group, amino acid group and R group, okay. So, amino acid that contains hydrogen group, one hydrogen will be present, next carboxyl group, carboxyl will be present, amino group. So, three group must be present and another one R group, okay. And depends on the R group, there are 20 types of the amino acid are present, okay. So, the depends on the R group, 20 types of amino acid are present in our earth, okay. Only that made up of protein made amino acids only, the protein made amino acids are 20 types, okay. And that depends on the R group, which that may be hydrogen, that may be amino group, anything that must be present. So, depends on the R group, 20 types protein made amino acids, okay. Types that depends on the R group, there are 20 types protein made amino acid. R group depends on the R groups, there are 3 types, okay. So, R groups that divided the amino acid into 3 types. If hydrogen present, okay, that is called glycine, okay. If hydrogen present, hydrogen group present, in the case of the R group, if hydrogen present in the place of the R, if hydrogen present, that is called glycine, okay, glycine. If you have seen the glycine, that is one carboxyl group, that is one carboxyl group, okay. Next, attached to attached with the carbon, one carbon must be present, another one amino acid group, one hydrogen group, okay. These three must be present in any type of amino acid, carboxyl group, amino group, hydrogen group, and another one R group that present in this area, okay. And depends on this part, there is 20 types of the amino acid, that is hydrogen. If there is another hydrogen is also present, that is called glycine, okay. So, depends on the R group, there are 3 types of the amino acid, that is glycine, alanine and serine, okay. Glycine means one carboxyl group, one amino group, one hydrogen group. These three are common in each amino acids, okay. But there is different in the R group. When R group contains hydrogen, that one is called glycine. When the R group contains methyl group, when the R group contains methyl group, so COOH obviously present, NH2 amino group present, hydrogen present, only methyl, okay. There will be no hydrogen, there will be methyl group, okay. That is called alanine. So, when the R group contains hydrogen, this is called glycine. When the R group contains methyl group, that is called alanine. And when the R group contains hydroxymethyl, that is called serine, okay. And when that contains hydroxymethyl, CH to OH, okay? When it is called hydroxymethyl, that is called serine. Okay, so this one is the R group. Depends on the R group, three types of the amino acids are present. Now lipids, okay, you know that lipids and fatty acids are also important. So depends on the lipids and fatty acid, so there is the oil also formed, there is phospholipid, glyceride, triglyceride, phosphoglyceride, the diglyceride, monoglyceride are also present. So when the fatty acids or lipids, okay, fatty acids or lipids means that is made up of one carboxyl group and another one R group. Okay, lipids, carboxyl group means you know that carboxyl group plus R group. Carboxyl group means C double OH, and R group that methyl or ethyl. Okay, methyl or ethyl. That is CH3, CCH3. Okay, so this will be present in the any type of fat or lipids. That will be CH3 or CH2H5. Okay, methyl group or ethyl group. So lipid is made up of carboxyl group and one R group. R group may be methyl, may be ethyl. Okay, there is so many fatty acids are present that contains carbons. Carbons are always present because they are biomolecules. You know that the carbon contains materials are called biomolecules. So there must be a carbon present, one carboxyl group present, one R group present. Okay, and the carbon, how many carbons are present? That included the carbon plus that present in the carboxyl group and R group. Okay, so that's why the palmitic acid contains. So there is very short type of question, how many carbons are present in the palmitic acid? That is 16 carbons including carboxyl groups carbons. Okay, methyl groups carbons, the carbons that join the two parts, and another one carboxyl groups carbon. Palmitic acid, that is one type of fatty acid, palmitic acid, that contain 16 carbon. Palmitic acid contains 16. Arachidonic acid, arachidonic acid, this is very short type of question, how many carbons are present in palmitic acid, how many arachidonic, arachidonic acids, that is arachidonic acid, that is contains 20 carbons. Okay, this is important question, short type of question, how many carbons are present. Fatty acid are two types, depends on the double bond, saturated and unsaturated. Saturated fatty acid means without any double bond, and unsaturated fatty acid means one or more double bond. Saturated fatty acid and unsaturated, okay. Saturated fatty acids mean without double bond. Unsaturated means with one or more CC double bond, okay. So that contains double bond. That is oil. You know that oils and some fatty acid contains low melting points, okay. So that's why oils are remain oils in the winter. That never be solid form, that always in the liquid form, because their melting point is very low. Okay, so this is one type of short question, why the oil remains oil in the winter also, because it is unsaturated fatty acids and that's got the content double bond, and that's remain the oil in any type of the condition. Okay, because of the low melting point, some fatty acid contains very low melting point, that is one of them is the oil. So that's why oils remains oils in the winter condition also. Now nucleic acid, so protein completed, fatty acid completed, now nucleic acid. You know that nucleic acid, you have already read in the structure of the DNA, adenine, guanine, cytosine, thymidine and uracil. So these are present in the structure of DNA and RNA. These four are present in the DNA and this replaced in the RNA, thymine and uracil. Okay, thymine. So when the nucleic acid attached with the sugar, that is called nucleosides. Okay, so when the nucleic acid attached with sugar, this is called nucleosides. Then these name are changed into adenosine, guanosine, thymosine. Okay, nucleic acid when attached with the sugar, it's called nucleosides. That is thymidine, adenosine, adenosine. Okay, this is called nucleosides. When there is another phosphate group are attached with the nucleoside, it is called nucleotides. Then it is adenylic acid, guanylic acid. Okay, nucleic acid plus sugar equal to nucleosides plus phosphate group, it's called nucleotides. Nucleotides when that is it is acid form. Okay, adenylic acid nucleotides, nucleotides, there is adenylic acid, guanylic acid, this type of name will be formed. Okay, adenylic acid. Okay, so DNA and RNA is made up of this type of nucleotides, and you know that what is the functions of the DNA and RNA, mainly they are act as the genetic material. Okay, so we have completed the proteins, fatty acids and nucleic acids. Now there is some metabolisms are also present, that is primary metabolism and secondary metabolism. You just give the name, give some example of primary metabolism, metabolites, that is primary metabolites. That is flavonoids, alkaloids, flavonoids, and secondary metabolism that is formed after the primary metabolism, that is rubber, drugs, medicine, anything. Okay, that is secondary metabolism. Okay, so This is up to further today. We have learned what is biomolecule, what is inorganic, which one is the organic, what is the amino acid, the different structure and R group of the amino acids, how what is glycerin, serine, alanine, how many types of the carbon, how many carbons are present in the palmitic acid, arachidonic acids, and there is some nucleic acids are also present, what is nucleotides, nucleosides, and the primary metabolites and secondary metabolites. Okay, so this is up to further today. We will discuss next the rest part in our next video. Thank you very much everyone. Bye everyone.